I'm making a chocolate and pear cake. It's so delicious. And it's loosely based on the classic dessert, pear belle Helene, which is poached pears with chocolate sauce. So I'll start with poaching the pears, and I'm going to be using the Ingenio set. I love it because it comes with a pot, a sauté pan just like this, and also a regular pan. And the best thing about it, it's all stackable. So if you've got small storage spaces at home, it fits like a glove. It also has a detachable handle, so it's easy to flip cakes. Okay, so in here I've got some water. I'll add some cinnamon, so just one cinnamon stick, and one star anise, some sugar, just caster sugar, and this is a sugar syrup that the pears are going to be poached in. I also love the addition of a little sherry, so some dry sherry. As that sugar starts to dissolve, we'll add the pears. Now I'm using some Burr Bosque pears. It does have the brown skin. I've peeled that off. I've also taken the core out. And because I've done this ahead of time, to make sure that they don't oxidise, it's important to place them in some water that's been acidulated so they stay that gorgeous colour. So in they go. So once it comes to the boil, I'm going to turn it down and just cook the pears for about 8 minutes or until they're tender. It will depend on how ripe your pears are. Lid on so they cook evenly. I'm going to get started on the first component of the cake, which is lots of butter and chocolate. So over here I have a bain-marie, so a little water in a pot. We'll add our chocolate, use really good quality chocolate for this. So I'm using some 70% Lindt dark chocolate, and we'll just break up the pieces straight into the bowl. So after this chocolate has melted with our butter, just let that melt away and then we'll allow it to cool. Okay, the pears are cooked and they've cooled down, and now for the rest of the cake. So everything's at the same temperature, so in with the cream cheese, and you just want to separate it and whisk that cream cheese in. So once that starts to dissolve in, which it is now, we can add some cocoa powder and stir that through, and you'll see it stiffen up, but don't worry, we're going to be adding some eggs soon, and some sugar, lots of sugar for this, and this is what makes it super fudgy. And I'll remove the whisk back to a wooden spoon and then give this a really good mix. Now for the eggs. So I've got 4 eggs here. I'm just going to crack them into a bowl, give them a whisk, and then just slowly incorporate the egg until we've got a nice batter. Fudgy now, but we do need to add some flour, so some self-raising flour. I'll fold this in, and then if it's too thick, I'll also add a splash of milk. Well, this just looks good enough to eat as is. Look how rich and glossy it is. Fantastic. We'll pop that to the side for a moment and we can prepare our pears. So we'll take the plastic lid off, and you can keep this syrup. It's so delicious. And depending on the size of pan that you're going to use, you may only need just a few pears. The rest can just stay in here in the fridge for at least a week. So I'm going to be using the 26 centimetre pan, and usually you would do this in a cake tin, but I love doing it in this pan because it's got a heavy base, so it's going to cook nice and evenly. I've placed a little bit of baking paper. I'm going to get that lovely shape for the cake. So I'm going to cut the pears in half. You can leave the stalk on if you like for presentation, but I'm just going to take them off and just pop them in the pan. You can be really pedantic with it or just get them in like I'm doing, because I kind of like the idea of everyone getting a big chunk of pear as they cut into it. So I'm not going to worry about sort of fanning them out or anything like that. And this is the perfect amount of pears if you want that chocolate to pear ratio to be even. Look at that. And we can pour our chocolate batter over the top now and just let it seep through so it hits the bottom and in and around those pears. And once you've added all of that cake batter, spread it out so each of the pears are coated. This then goes into the oven, 180 degrees, for about 35 to 40 minutes, or until it's got a gorgeous crust and it's still a little fudgy in the centre. Promised a crispy chocolate top, and I love how all the pears are poking out. I just think it's just so lovely breaking into this at the table when everyone's sitting down. Lots of oohs and ahs will happen, and then just serving this fudgy, peary delight. All right, look at that. See, it's like a delicious big chocolate brownie with loads of pears through it. Fantastic. And I'll add a little icing sugar, just a small amount. And you can't have this hot dessert without some really cold dollop cream. So a spoonful of that on top. Just let that fall off the spoon. And that, my friends, is an absolute delight. Chocolate and pears go so well together. I'll have a taste. A little cream. The chocolate is so rich and fudgy, and that addition of the pears really cuts through that richness. That right there is a match made in heaven. Oh, it's good.